Holy Gospel according to Luke. The tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to him. But the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them he addresses this parable. Then he said, "A man had two sons, and the younger son said to his father, 'Father, give me the share of your estate that should come to me.' So the father divided the property between them. After a few days, the younger son collected all his belongings and set off to a distant country where he squandered his inheritance on a life of dissipation. When he had freely spent everything, a severe famine struck that country, and he found himself in dire need. So he hired himself out to one of the local citizens, who sent him to his farm to tend the swine, and he longed to eat his fill of the pods on which the swine fed, but nobody gave him any. Coming to his senses, he thought, 'How many of my father's hired workers have more than enough food to eat? But here I am, dying from hunger. I shall get up and go to my father, and I shall say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as you would treat one of your hired workers.' So he got up and went back to his father. While he was still a long way off, his father caught sight of him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, embraced him, and kissed him. His son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son.' But his father ordered his servants, 'Quickly, bring the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Take the fattened calf and slaughter it. Then let us celebrate with a feast, because this son of mine was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found.' Then the celebration began. Now the older son had been out in the field, and on his way back, as he neared the house, he heard the sound of music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked what this might mean. The servant said to him, 'Your brother has returned, and your father has slaughtered the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound.' He became angry, and when he refused to enter the house, his father came out and pleaded with him. He said to his father in reply, 'Look, all these years I served you, and not once did I disobey your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat to feast on with my friends. But when your son returns, who swallowed up your property with prostitutes, for him you slaughter the fattened calf.' He said to him, 'My son, you are here with me always. Everything I have is yours. But now we must celebrate and rejoice, because your brother was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You're my first love. tear out of grace. Not a flaw can erase the beauty of your face. You are my true love. There is wonder in your gaze.
Friend, do you feel lost? Then today's gospel is for you. Let me start by saying that the parable of the prodigal son is only found in the Gospel of Luke. There's no parable of the prodigal son in Matthew or Mark or John. Next, the parable of the prodigal son is actually a series of three parables that Jesus told in this span of Bible verses. The first was the parable of the lost sheep. The second was the parable of the lost coin, and the third was the parable of the prodigal son. Now you may be asking, why is that important? Because these three parables combined shows the heart of God for the lost. That's why I told you, if you feel lost, this parable is for you. God is speaking to you. It also helps to see the background of this context. And it's found in Luke chapter 15, verses 1 to 2, the first few verses of our gospel today. It's written there, tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus. Friend, if you feel that you are a sinner, like I sometimes do, you will be blown away that God is specifically talking to you and to me. He's saying that his heart is delighted when we are found. The shepherd was delighted when he found the lost sheep. The woman was delighted when she found the lost coin. The father was delighted when the prodigal son came back. Oh, my dear friends, God is delighted when he finds you and me. God is delighted when we are reconciled with him. God is telling you and me, I would throw a party when you return, just like he did for the prodigal son. And it's not just a party. You know what? In the series of parables, he says, listen to this, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not need to repent. That's in Luke chapter 15, verse 7. Friend, God wants to reconcile with you and me. Again, my dear friend, I'd like to ask you, do you feel lost? I have good news for you. If you feel lost or if you feel far from God, I'm pretty sure, number one, hindi ang Diyos ang lumayo sa iyo. And I'm very sure, number two, ikaw at ako ang lumayo sa Diyos. So if you feel lost and if you feel far from God, I encourage you, and I would like to encourage myself too. Let's go back to God now. Make God happy, not tomorrow, but today. Let the heavens rejoice today because of you and me. Let God find you today. Let's pray. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you rejoice when we repent. We thank you that you constantly look for us until you find us. Thank you for breaking through our stubborn hearts. Lord, we pray for the grace and the courage to constantly go back to you. May we never get tired of asking for your forgiveness, as you never get tired of forgiving us. This we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.